Hey guys, it's Colby from Muffler Tech and PriusCats.com. Today I'm coming to you with another Prius video that's kind of adding to my series here, and I want to talk to you about the car that's directly behind me. This is a Gen 3 car, 2010 to 2015. We are starting to see these fairly frequently now for theft, and I want to talk to you about some of the important differences between this car and the earlier generation cars. So first off, let's talk about the kind of how you tell the difference between a Gen 3 and a Gen 2 for those people that are not as familiar. The main thing that I look for is the different headlight design and the different taillight design. So if you look at up here towards the top of this taillight area right here, the Gen 3 car, the taillight runs up into the structure of the trunk lid here, whereas the Gen 2 cars do not. Give me a minute here, I'll show you that. So here we have a Gen 2 car to show you the difference, and I always have plenty of Priuses to sample here to give you an example, but this is something that gets confused quite a bit because the Gen 2 cars and the Gen 3 cars look very similar. It was just a mild update when they went to Gen 3, but if you look at the taillight design here, how it ends, and then there's a painted section right here that runs into the rear hatch assembly, that's the easiest way to tell from the rear of the car. Anyway guys, that's enough about styling differences. Let's talk about catalytic converters, because that's what this video is really about. What we have here is two complete factory assemblies. The one closest to us is a Gen 2, and the one furthest away is a Gen 3. Now, if you look at the Gen 3, you can see we've already done our level 1 theft prevention on it with the rod stock. And if you're interested in seeing more about our theft prevention techniques, I'm going to put a link to our video that's specific to that topic down below. But what we're looking at here is the difference in the complexity of the parts. Now, the Gen 2 is one off our shelf here for stock, and so we have all the components that we need here taped to it. This doesn't have anything to do necessarily with this discussion, but that's like the lower O2 sensor and some gaskets. But mainly what I want to show you the difference is up front here, you can see there's two separate converters. This is our front converter here, which is closest to the exhaust manifold. And then the exhaust runs back. Here's where the O2 sensor, the downstream, is located. And then we go into the secondary the secondary catalytic converter. When they steal them off Gen 2s, this is what they're after, just this part right here. So in other words, from this point forward, they don't care about that, is which a resonator there, and then there's a pipe that leads back to the muffler. This piece here has zero value, speaking to its recyclability and getting any sort of precious metals out of it, because there isn't any in here. The precious metals are contained in this cat and in this cat here. So when they steal a Gen 2, this is where they're cutting it. And again, if you look at my other videos on my channel, there's a lot of other information on this topic, but to address what I'm talking about specific to this video is very easily here, even if you don't know anything about automotive or mechanics, you can very easily tell visually the differences between the basic nature of a Gen 2 versus a Gen 3. Now, what's important to know about a Gen 3 is, again, we've got a cat here and a cat here. This is what they're after from here forward. When they do theft on a Gen 3, because of the complexity of the part, they chop all kinds of stuff up. So we have seen them be cut here. We have seen them use a saw and try to cut through all of this stuff here. There's an actuator here that opens a valve for coolant circulation. And that's what probably the most important thing to talk about is if you do experience the unfortunate event of somebody stealing your cat and you have a Gen 3 car, you absolutely should not drive it. The difference is when the Gen 2s get stolen, we can tell customers that don't have insurance or don't have tow coverage, go ahead and drive the car in. It's not going to hurt anything because we don't have cats hooked up. It's not going to hurt anything to the car. In this case, though, in the Gen 3, you can damage the car because this line here and this line down here are for coolant circulation, for cooling the interior of this part. And without the cat being on it, it's not the exhaust leak coming from where it would connect to the manifold that's the problem. What it is you've got hoses cut underneath the car that are gonna just drain all the coolant out of the engine, and then the engine's gonna overheat and you're gonna blow up your engine. So this particular car I want to show you, and it's interesting in that we don't see this very often. Most thieves are successful in their action as far as stealing them, but you can see on this one where these guys clearly botched it up very badly. They're using a Sawzall of some sort, so you can see the jagged cut here, and then up there where the blade is actually running into the heat shield on the car. And then they tried again right in this area. So as I explained on my new part, you can see where the saw right here was skipping around, and they took many attempts to cut a whole gap in it there. I can see the shard of metal hanging down here. And it does not appear they even tried to get up there and unbolt anything. Like the Gen 2 cars up there, that bolt, you can see the bolt head there, that's where it bolts to the exhaust manifold. But what I wanted to show you, and the main importance why this gentleman had to have his car towed in, is during that cutting, they separated the coolant line, and you can see this dripping out of here. This is coolant directly from the engine. If this customer would have operated this car without that hooked up on his way here, he would have pushed all the coolant out of the engine, and the car would have overheated. So in closing, guys, just want to make sure everybody's aware that the cat theft is still a very real thing. It's a thing to be concerned about. It applies more than just Priuses, but Priuses are still very much the targeted vehicle as we speak now during the time that I'm publishing this video. And you're not immune if you have a Prius, anything that's 2015 or older. So far, we haven't seen much, speaking to the 16 and newer cars, Gen 4 and newer cars. But awareness is important. Keep your insurance intact. As always, Muffler Tech is here to help you with any sort of replacement, any sort of insurance claim. Please see our webpage, PriusCats.com. I will continue to put up videos on this topic specific to Priuses and theft and replacement and recommendations to you. Take a look at my channel. I've got a lot of other videos on this topic. The most important one, and surprisingly the one that's not watched or that I have the lowest amount of views on, is insurance. It's not very exciting, I'll be honest, but the information is really good. And if you drive a Prius of any year, I recommend you take a minute and watch that video. I'll have a link to that in the description below as well. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Subscribe if you like what I have to say. I'm open to criticism if you don't. So have an awesome day. PriusCats.com, everybody. See you later.